medication against the pain. Our bodies fit desperately together like a needle against a vein. Poppy flower is so beautiful, gentle as a lover's touch. A touch is just a touch of strong medicine, and it's possible to take too much. We take it for comfort, to take away the pain for us. A poppy flower is beautiful, and a thousand poppies is dangerous. Seems to change my mind. I got a weakness for strong chemistry. One touch, all my resolutions change. I can say this is no good for me, but I'm back for more of the same. High on the ecstasy, medication against the pain. Our bodies fit desperately together like a needle against a vein. I got weak for strong chemistry. My resolutions.
Terrific. David, what's the name of that?
I call that Strong Chemistry.
Excellent. Visual song.
Yeah. I try to make sure that the images that I use are pretty accessible. I like the ones that are just sort of in front of us all the time, because I like to write songs that are what I believe in, also what I'm, you know, trying to believe. And so if I give myself reminders that are everywhere around me, then, you know, I can reach for the best that I've touched on in the worst of times.
How would you describe your songwriting process? Is it painful?
I'd say that it's never been something that I felt like I've worked at. It's always felt like stolen time. You know, I ought to be doing this, I ought to be doing that, I ought to be getting a real job, whatever. But but I just find myself wanting to, oh, there's this idea, oh, there's this guitar riff. And
driven.
Yeah, so I'm the kind of person who will, like, remember at 7 o'clock in the evening that I haven't had breakfast yet because there's been this song. So,
yeah.
It's kind of...
Who were some of your influences early on?
I've really loved a lot of different kinds of music, but I'd say it was the kind of coffee house level kind of performers that really stirred me, because I saw that music was not just something for the professionals to do. It was too important to that. You know, you have to,
right.
You have to take it into your own hands. So I really like that feeling of music just person to person, and it being not just making up a song that sounds like something you've heard, but
right. If
there's something you need to say that you can't say with words, that's when a song can help.
Who do you listen to now?
My favorite is The Story. The Story is a band, two women, Jonathan and Jennifer, and they live in Massachusetts. Their album's on Green Linnet, but it's going to be re-released on Elektra probably about a month or so. And I think they're amazing. Have you played them on the station?
I'm afraid not.
Gotta get it. It's great. Ooh, it's really great
stuff. What are they comparable to?
They draw on a lot of stuff that's happened in the last couple of years. I mean, the last lot of years, but... I'd like to think of it as, the sound of their voices is a little bit like maybe Suzanne Vega combined with a lot of other images. A lot of there's some Sean Colvin kind of sound to it, but
great.
It's not the same phrasing. It's real intricate harmony. Imagine if you had a big complex 5 or 6 part harmony and you took all the boring parts out and what's left are, you know, the ninth and the, you know, it's just kind of hangs where the chord fills in underneath with the guitar and you understand why those voices are there. But at the same time, it's so nice.
Sounds pretty good.
They're great. And the lyrics are real straightforward.
Have you ever played with them?
Yeah, I shared a gig in Philadelphia and in Boston, and we sang together some.
Great. Are they touring or?
Yeah, they're touring a bunch. And right now it's the small club circuit. And in a year, I'm sure I'll be opening for them
great.
If I'm lucky.
Great.
Because they're going to be hot.
Where are you headed from here?
I'm going to play in Winchester, Virginia tomorrow night, and I'm working on this new album, and so I'm spending a lot of time just on pre-production and writing. I have a new song that I wrote yesterday, but I don't have the lyric here. I'd love to play it on the radio. It'd be fun. But,
well, that's all right. I'm sure.
So I'm working on this new album, and it should be about half done in a month or so, and then we'll record the other half along about August or so.
Excellent.
Actually, it'll probably be first quarter next year.
Really?
Just because of the record company's schedule. Yeah.
It is on the way, though.
Yeah.
Great.
Great. Well, you've already got two albums.
Actually, I got 3 albums out, but the first one is on an independent label. The first one's called The Night Shift Watchman, and it's on a label called Song of the Wood.
Wow.
So let's see. What do I need to play? If anybody out there listening has a particular song, call us up, tell me. Let's see. This is a fun one.
What do you think you're going to concentrate on tonight, David?
It depends on the crowd.
Really?
I like to think that the energy in the crowd is something that you have to really, you know, watch, and you can't just play the same songs night after night and
sure.
expect it to always work.
Gauge the audience.
It's like running a whitewater river, you know? you can't control it. You can't say, oh, it's going to go this way. You just have to listen and watch, and if you know it well enough, you can get it to put you where you want to go.
I like that.
But you can't fight it.
That's nice.
That fills you up. Try to pour on sweet affection, but I think you got a broken cup. Because you can't believe I love you. I try to tell you that there is no doubt, but as soon as I fill you with all I've got, that little break will let it run right out. I cannot make you happy. I'm learning love and money never do. But I can pour myself out till I'm empty, trying to be just who you'd want me to. I cannot make you happy, even though our love is true. For there's a break in the cup that holds love inside of you. I began to understand you as you explain this fear you feel. It's when you see me fall into that sorrow that makes you doubt the love is real. Because the lonely wind still blows through me, I turn away so you can't see. Now how could I still be so empty with all the love that you pour on me? I guess you cannot make me happy. That's just a money back guarantee. But you can pour yourself out till you're empty, trying to be just who I'd want you to be. You cannot make me happy. It's just the law of gravity and that break in the cup that holds love inside of me. You're tempted to rescue me, drowning in that quicksand up to my neck. Before you grab my hand to save me, why don't you ask me if I'm finished yet? For you cannot make me happy when I don't even want to be. But you can pull yourself right in here with me. My misery'd love to have your company. But if I truly want to be happy, I can pray for that missing piece to the break in the cup that holds love. To that break in the cup that holds love. To that break in the cup that holds love inside of me, inside of me.
David Wilcox in the studios of WVVV Rock 105. Glad to have him here tonight. David will be at South Main Cafe tonight in Blacksburg at 9 o'clock, so be sure to make your way on over there. David, who else is going to be with you? Did you tell me? Said a lot of people.
I'm not sure that... let's see. There is an opening act, I think, but I'm not sure.
As far as the stage maybe and not. Everything, the lot of people up there with you. And
It's going to be... I'll be performing solo, but it's going to be real crowded, so there'll be probably extra seating, you know, just all around.
So be
where
sure
we can find it.
To come on down and get your seats early on. What kind of guitar is that, David?
This is a James Olson guitar. James Olson is this wonderful man who lives up in Minneapolis, and it's the sweetest guitar. I've been on a long quest to
sounds
find
excellent.
A guitar like this.
How long have you been playing it?
This one I've had less than a year, maybe 6 months
really?
Or so. Yeah. Looks a little worn, but...
Well, no, I as attached you seem to it, I thought you may have had it for a long time. I guess you plan to keep it for a while, don't you?
Actually, I've got another one on order.
I got a buck here. I'll buy it, man. You play any other instruments, David? Do you play any other instruments?
I mess around with a lot of other instruments, but I perform with guitar.
Really?
Yeah, I really enjoy getting... That's why I change the tunings on guitars, because I love... the feeling of just that amateur kind of wonder.
Yeah, you were telling John and I a little earlier about the process of playing a guitar instead of having it play you.
Yeah, I do like that. I like to get the big sound out of the guitar, but not by any gymnastics on my part,
sure.
Just by listening to where the real resonance is. And
what kind of tuning process were you telling us about?
Well, this is a real strange tuning. I have a capo that has a hole cut in it, so one string passes all the way through it, so I can get a real low bass sound and still get the real fine tone of a wound string fretted up high. So this is kind of a... Good question. Let me think. I think it's kind of like an open C with a 9 and a... what would this be? A major
that's
7?
That's your M chord.
Anyway.
That's next to the O chord. Okay.
I like to really not know what I'm doing, because that way it can be a surprise to
there
me.
There you go.
I find that when I go and watch people play, I can be moved by a song a whole lot more if I don't look at the guitar, because then I'm not thinking, oh, I know what he's doing.
Sure.
And I like music to just bypass the... cognitive comparison kind of stuff and just
take kind of a zen approach, maybe.
Yeah. Dear Mom and Dad, here's why I can't come home.
'Cause I can talk with either one of you just fine when it's either one alone. But the Thanksgiving table is going to be pulled out bigger. If we talk at all, one of you will pull the trigger. And I used to run those battle lines, trying to plead and to implore. Please, won't you hold the ceasefire out a little longer until the next uproar? I took it on in childhood, but I can't take it no more. I caught too much crossfire in your covert war. The television talks and fills the air, so you don't have to start. You claim your territories in the rooms upstairs to keep yourselves apart. Holy days, they bring us all together after so much left unsaid. You taught us well not to kick under the table, kick under your breath instead. And I used to stand between you, trying to smooth over what God said. Trying to get a medal, trying to get some shrapnel in my head. I thought it was my duty to plead and to implore. I caught too much crossfire in your covert war. Of course there will be anger where the love is strong, spilled like gasoline. Crude, but it's a power we can draw upon if it fuels the right machine. But I love you and I'd never want to see you bleed when comments cut like steel. So to hold your fire, I'd block the shot, take the hit for you as if I could not feel. I thought they passed right through me, and I had no scars to hide. But now I open up and try to love and find they're still inside. 'Cause I used to run those battle lines, trying to plead and to implore. Please, won't you hold the ceasefire out a little longer until the next uproar? I took it on in childhood, but I can't take it no more. 'Cause I caught too much crossfire in your covert war.
Very nice.
Thanks.
David, what's it like to put an album out?
Well, it's, to me, I consider it like an invitation. I send out all these invitations and I'm not sure where they go. You take all your best hopes and dreams and you, like, make a little letter and you chuck it in a bottle and you throw it in the ocean and maybe somebody gets it. And if they get it, then to me, it's an invitation to come hear some music live, because that's what I think the real juice is, and that's where a lot of my hope comes from. I tend to just get a strong vision of the way I want my life to feel from music, and so I just follow it like a compass that lines itself up with something bigger.
You're listening to David Wilcox in the studios of WVVV Rock 105. This is Chris. And David is going to be at South Main tonight in Blacksburg, South Main Cafe. Doors open probably earlier than 9 because he's going to start playing right around 9 o'clock.
I think they're serving dinner and stuff around 7 and 8, yeah. And I'll probably stop dinner around 8 just so they can get everything cleared.
You like playing venues like that?
I like playing a lot of different things. I like there to be a focus, and that room feels like it's going to be a good emotional focus.
Yeah.
And that comes in all different sizes. It just depends on the design and the intent of the people who run it.
Mm-hmm. How much touring, David, do you like to?
I used to tour almost all the time, and I found that I love writing so much, I want to really take time for that. So now I'm out about half the time. And that gives me a life that's worth writing about.
What's half the time? Half of a year or half of a block of time that you've designated for music? Or
what I like to do is just make sure that it balances month to month. So I might be out for a week and home for a week, or I might be out for 2 weeks and home for 2 weeks, or it just might be a lot of little short trips with a lot of little time in between.
How far in advance do you know that you're going to be somewhere?
There's some gigs that are booked a year in advance, and a lot are shaping up in the next, you know, couple months. Mm-hmm.
Well, I think your message is being received by a lot of people. It's a good message, too.
Thanks.
Good stuff.
I like it to be good for you. I like to, when I listen to the radio, I like to believe that this person is really respecting my journey, this person singing on the radio that I'm listening to in my car or whatever. I like to think that their music is sending out the best that they've come up with, you know, because we all start out with bad directions.
Mm-hmm. Sure. Kind of bring it into a higher path, maybe.
I like to.
If David Wilcox had to be compared to someone, who would David like for David to be compared to?
There are a lot of people who compare the kind of emotional thing with James Taylor, and I like that. I learned a lot of my guitar riffs from John Martin and Nick Drake. And the writing, I would say I'd like to be compared to Greg Brown or, I don't know, let's see, who else? I just heard, never mind, it's just bragging. I heard through the grapevine that somebody asked James, a lot of people are comparing David Wilcox to you, what do you think about that? And he says, I'm a big David Wilcox fan.
Great.
Have you ever met him?
Yeah, I have. Wonderful man, very kind.
Great. Excellent. Of course, how much did your guys' paths cross in the Carolinas?
Well, not in the Carolinas. We met in Telluride. We were both playing the Telluride Bluegrass Festival.
Wow. Yeah. What do you think of bluegrass?
Well, I think this next year, Telluride is going to be the place to be because rumor has it there's going to be a reunion of... Walking on the railroad rails, out across this deep commitment, I can feel your fingernails hanging on to old resentment. And I miss that easy smile. Lately it's a tight wire frown, but we've come so many miles, we can make it if we don't look down. The balance is no harder after all. Out across this bridge so tall, the balance is no harder. It's just that we've got farther. Now we just got farther to fall. Farther to fall. And looking all the way down in it, maybe we'll drown in it. You like to walk this rail for two, as long as words like wife aren't said. Something comes over you when you see that span of life ahead. So now you make your choice. Will you turn around and walk away? Tremble in your voice, you turn to me and smile and say, the balance is no harder after all. Out across this bridge so tall, the balance is no harder. It's just that we've got farther. Now we just got farther to fall. The balance is no harder. It's just that we've got farther.
Now we just got farther to fall.
More than excellent. Thank you, David.
Thanks,
David
much.
Wilcox. He's in the studios at WVVV, Rock 105. David will be at South Main Cafe tonight at 9 o'clock. It is 6:47. We'll be back. Hey, thanks much, Skippy. It is 6:51 Saturday evening as the sun tries to set on us just a bit. 71 degrees, still holding steady at 71. Partly cloudy for the rest of this evening. We do still have a 30% chance of rain out there. Lows are going to be in the mid-50s for tonight. For tomorrow, partly cloudy, 50-50 chance of wet stuff tomorrow. High's going to be in the low 70s, so that's how we're looking weather-wise. But I'll tell you what, tonight, doesn't matter whether it's rain or dry, it's going to be a great show over at South Main Cafe. David Wilcox is going to be at South Main Cafe in Blacksburg at 9 o'clock tonight. Get there early. And David was kind enough to come here to the studios to give us some sampling of his work. What are we thinking about, David?
Got one.
Great.
By the way,
congratulations. It seems like you're the master of the smooth transition.
Oh.
I mean, to go from weather to a gig, that's I like.
Why, thank you.
Okay, here's a song that, in the face of all this kind of worries and stuff and $1 trillion national debts and $400 billion deficit and all that kind of stuff, you know, you might start to get a little worried.
Well, I don't look all that ragged for all the time it's been, but I'm weakened underneath me where my frame is rusted thin. And this year's state inspection I just barely passed. Won't you drive me across the country? Boy, this year could be my last. I'm that tail fin rowing locomotive from the days of cheap gasoline. And I'm for sale by the side of the road going nowhere. A rusty old American dream. I rolled off the line in Detroit back in 1958. Spent 3 days in the showroom, that's all I had to wait. I've been good to all who owned me, so have no fear. Come on, boy, put your money down and get me out of here. I'm that tail fin road locomotive from the day of cheap gasoline, and I'm for sale by the side of the road going nowhere. Rusty old American dream. Now this car needs a young man to own him, one who will polish the chrome, and I will give you the rest of my lifetime, but don't let me die here alone. Just jump me some juice to my battery. Give that old starter a spin. Hear me whir, sputter, backfire through the carburetor, roar into life once again. I am that tail fin road locomotive. You can polish my chrome so clean. We can fly off into the sunset together, a rusty old American dream. Still running, a rusty old American dream.
I like that.
Thanks.
Nice. Very nice. So, tonight, the big gig. You get nervous anymore, David?
I do. I try to just use the energy and just say my prayers and make sure I'm focused on why I'm there. And
great.
And if I'm nervous, it's usually because I'm thinking I'm there because I'm, you know, like I have something great to offer. And
right.
Then obviously that would be a good reason to be nervous because it's not true.
Right.
But if I just get out of the way and let the music happen, then it seems to
take
serve
you over.
Me well.
Yeah, great. How long do you like to play generally?
It depends on the crowd there.
Yeah,
also, I'd say
cool. Yeah.
I'll do a couple sets tonight, probably a couple hour sets.
Great.
Or so.
What are some of the more memorable parts of the tour, or any tour rather, across the country or
I'd
wherever?
Say Scotland
really?
Was a lot of fun. I had been there before a long time ago, traveling, and to be back playing music was a real treat. This festival on the Isle of Skye, just a wonderful place.
Sounds nice.
Yeah.
Where else in Europe?
I have traveled a bunch over there. I haven't played music a bunch there, and I'm looking forward to that next year, too. That'll be fun.
Great. So, well, David, I don't know. What do you think?
I think I better go
further,
get ready for my sound check.
That's true. We are almost at 7, and I'm sure it takes you a while to get everything together properly.
Get it dialed in.
Sure. Sure, I understand that.
David, thanks for having me.
Hey, David, we thank you very much for coming on by. You're listening to WVVV Rock 105. Mr. David Wilcox has been with us for the past hour, entertaining us with some of his fine sounds. He'll be at South Main Cafe in Blacksburg tonight at 9 o'clock, so be sure to check him out there. Great music, great music. Once again, David, we thank you very much.
Thanks. See you again.
Okay, all right, David. Let's see. What are we going to do now? Let's go ahead and get into some recorded rock and roll. Billy Joel, WVVV, Rock 105 FM.